Yeah, first and foremost, I say just jump right in it. If you have an idea, if you have sort of a vision, you know, if you have more of an entrepreneurial role, don't hold yourself back. I think too often women think that they're not good enough. They're sort of thinking about, do I tick all of the check boxes? Don't think about this, more think about what is the idea. Go see your peers, go see women that are, you know, more experienced, and don't hesitate to sort of share your concerns, share questions, have questions, you know, ask for their experience. You know, you'll always get an answer whether you like it or not. The second is really sort of also think of building a network, and it doesn't only have to be of women. I certainly have big major networks with men, but sort of build an environment in which you feel safe and an environment that can be constructive for your growth. And for where you want to be. Having trusted peers to discuss, you know, issues that they're encountering in their everyday job, I think is critically important. And then for working moms like me, I think just having informal networks as well of how we're trying to balance work life and the children. I think that's considerably important. The biggest challenge that I see from the perspective of women, and particularly young women, is the fact that they don't necessarily have the confidence that they need in order to be able to think big, think more ambitiously, and sort of think creatively. There was really one female mentor who pushed me to think big and to build out a project and actually build up an organization in the climate space. Thanks to her mentorship, thanks to her guidance, thanks to her coaching and motivation, really pushed me to, you know, push the boundaries of myself, but also what women could be doing in the space. And then last but not least is really make sure that you have the confidence that you need, and don't hold yourself back.